This is very important to me. I believe that I can do more.
Hasn't that been the problem all along? Throughout your career, you've had lofty goals, but you've never been willing to do what's necessary to attain them.
Would that be your evaluation as well, Commander? I think I have to agree with the counselor. If you want to get ahead, you have to take chances. Stand out in a crowd. Get noticed.
I see.
Now, we don't want to lose you. You're a very good officer.
Just not one who stands out.
Why don't I talk to Commander LaForge in engineering and see what we can do?
But command.
Well, we'll see.
Senior officers, please report to the captain's ready room.
Acknowledged.
We should talk about this later.
All right, Q, that's enough. You've made your point. Q.
LaForge to Lieutenant Picard. I'm still waiting for that statistical analysis.
I'm on my way, sir. Main engineering. Having a good laugh now, Q. Does it amuse you to think of me living out the rest of my life as a dreary man in a tedious job?
I gave you something most mortals never experience. A second chance at life. And now all you can do is complain?
I can't live out my days as that person. That man is bereft of passion and imagination. That is not who I am.
Au contraire. He's the person you wanted to be. One who was less arrogant and undisciplined in his youth. One who was less like me. The Jean-Luc Picard you wanted to be, the one who did not fight the Nausicaan, had quite a different career from the one you remember. That Picard never had a brush with death, never came face to face with his own mortality, never realized how fragile life is or how important each moment must be. So his life never came into focus. He drifted through much of his career with no plan or agenda, going from one assignment to the next, never seizing the opportunities that presented themselves. He learned to play it safe. And he never, ever got noticed by anyone.